My name is Ariyo Daria-Toye, Convener Coalition in Defense of Nigerian Democracy. Today, I am Sowore.
So I am.
Today, I am Daddy Atta.
So I am too.
Today, I am Stephen Kefa.
So I am.
Today, I am Jones Abiru.
So I am too.
Today, I am every Nigerian
so
who has been oppressed, terrorized, maligned, and clamped down by this very insensitive, draconian junta.
Yes.
First, let me say that we have to come back to the area where we have to appropriately describe the person who is in power. We were deceived that we now have a born again as a president of Nigeria, and therefore we should not use the word general. But I want to tell Nigerians today, in order to further confirm what Professor Wole Inka said, that we are back to Abacha days, that today we have to restore from Mr. to General.
Yes.
So Nigerians can know that the person they are dealing with is General, military dictator.
Yes.
So that Nigerians can know that it's not just an administration, but a civilian junta.
Yes.
So when they hear the word junta, and they hear the word a general, so they will know that indeed the human rights are under threat.
Yes.
Like I've said before, we are not ignorant of the fact that we are under an administration that want to have its way without any dissent.
Yes.
This is an administration that is intolerant of the view of opposition. And let me say, we have not gotten to a level where we have threatened dog and babu with soaking blood.
Yes.
We have not threatened a parallel government, which Amechi said. We have not threatened bloodshed, which Malam El-Rufai said.
Yes.
And the person who said dog and babu with soaking blood is the president. Buhari.
Yes.
And we have not even gotten to that level. The people today who have locked up have only merely criticized them because of what they did wrong.
Yeah.
And we want to tell them that there was yesterday,
absolutely,
there is today,
yes,
and there is going to be a tomorrow. Those who are in power today will not be in power tomorrow.
Sure.
Tell President Muhammadu Buhari that he is just one Nigerian among everybody.
Yes.
Tell General Muhammadu Buhari that he is just one Nigerian among 200 millions of souls.
Yes.
Today we have in Nasoro a royal and executive president with no monarchical mindset.
Yes.
That is why people are leaving their state to go and pay homage, to go and complain about the security situation in their state.
Mm.
Yesterday, a delegation from Edo State was in Asuro.
Mm.
What have we become as a nation? You elected a president that doesn't have a responsibility to you until you have to come to Asuro to come and tell him that your state is burning. In the 21st century, you elected that kind of a president. This is unfortunate. This is ridiculous.
This
is uncomfortable. And I want to say, without any sense of regret whatsoever, that this mistake we made is today haunting us as a nation.
Yes, yes.
However, if the people have mistakenly found themselves in bondage, there must also be a way out of bondage.
Yes, yes, sure.
And that is why today we are agitating our people. We are telling them that they should not give up, they should not lose hope. They should continue to stand up for their right and insist that justice must be done.
Yeah, absolutely.
We are gathered here today to say that justice must be done to Jones Abiru, justice must be done to Omoyele Sowore, justice must be done for Stephen Kefa, and justice must be done for Daddy Atta. That is why we are here today. And we insist that these people must be free because they are prisoners of conscience and political prisoners under an administration that is insensitive to human
rights.
Believe me sincerely, the only reason why some of us are here, out there, is simply because out of grace. We are not better than anybody who has died or those who are in prison.
Yes.
We are not better.
Yes.
The casualties are not only those who are dead or those who are in prison. We are all casualties.
Yes.
And today we want to make it abundantly clear,
absolutely,
to those who are piloting the affairs of this nation, that they should kulu
temper.
That the tsunami is coming. Tell those who are piloting the affairs of Nigeria that the tsunami is coming. They should embrace wisdom, embrace knowledge, to know that tyranny can never reign forever.
We had
it once in Abacha, we truncated it. Now we have it, we are going to put an end to it. Thank you very much.